Hi everyone. Let's say this time I'm a production engineer, and every day the first thing I do in the morning right after coffee is to take a look at the evolution of the different key values of yesterday's shift, such as the generation and emission of my plant. It used to take me at least an hour every morning simply to get those values from our database, and we all know that time is something very precious. Since I've started working with DataLink, I was able to create a daily report that refreshed automatically with yesterday's values every time I open it. This report grants me the access to all the key values of the different units of my plant. As you can see, I can easily change from a unit to another, and from an area to another, and see that the data associated with it is changing. A bunch of other information, such as the unit type, the unit state, the unit measures, all comes from my PI system and are updated for each and every of my units. In this video, I will show you how easy it is to create such a report in a timely manner.
Since this is an exercise, I strongly recommend that you follow me and create your own report using the same functions, either with your own data or with the generic database available with the workshop. Feel free to press pause or rewind the video if some steps are just going too fast.
The first thing you need to do is to define the looks and content of your report. In my case, I want my report to contain the following information. First of all, I would need the period covered by my report. In this case, I'll be using Excel time functions to define a report that is covering from yesterday midnight to today midnight. To define the time value today, let's use the today function from Excel. As for yesterday, yesterday at midnight, since the default unit of time is the day in Excel, let's use once again the today function, but this time we'll just add a -1 to make it yesterday midnight. As for my static values associated to my units, I would like to display, first of all, the unit type, the equipment number, the unit state, and the output. The attributes that I want to follow through the day would be the following. So we got, first of all, the target in percent, the output in megawatt of unit, the power available, and the heat rate. Finally, I would also be interested in following some of the environmental parameters. Those would simply be the emission of sulfur oxide and nitrogen oxide, and the average over the last hour of the nitrogen oxide.
Once these attributes are defined, we will now create our drop-down list that will give us the ability to dynamically change from a unit to another one. This is also known as the route path. In order to create a more user-friendly report, well, we'll be using the Excel function concatenate to define the path to the unit we want to study, either by the area or the actual unit we want to show. To do so, let's start by clicking on the search button from the DataLink section. In the search panel, we can now navigate to the desired element and obtain the route for those. In this case, we're looking for the generation part of the Power Co. Section of our database. Once we get there, we can simply select a unit and split the route path just to show what we need. In our case, since we will set up the drop-down list to select either the area or the unit, well, we will cut the route path right after the generation section.
The next step would be to create drop-down lists for units and areas. Since we have two different areas and three units in each of them, here's the different values that we are going to set up as a drop-down list. So we got area 1, area 2, and for the units, well, it's very simple. It's a unit 1, unit 2, and unit 3. To create a list, simply select the data tab in Excel and then choose data validation from it. In the data validation window, you will have two validation criteria to fill. The first one in the allo section is to simply select list, And after that, well, all there is left to do is to select the source for your list. In this case, it will be the different areas for the first dropdown and the different units for the second one. All there is left to do is to create a root path that will be used to point the function to the right element we want to study. To do so, simply create an Excel concatenate function that will use the first section of the root path we've already got from the search panel, then the area from the dropdown list, and finally the unit from the other dropdown list. Once this is done, you now have a completely dynamic path well-defined for your user to play with. In the report, we want to study the evolution of the values over the last day for a time interval of 1 hour. Since this daily report is an overview of yesterday's operation, this time interval would be really appropriate. To obtain the data associated to the different attributes, I will be using two of the three different functions available in the multiple data section of PyDataLink. Let's start with the sample data function. This function will return values over a specific period of time, in our case yesterday, following a specific time interval, in our case 1 hour. To open a function, well, all you need to do is simply click on it, and we can then start filling the different fields needed for this function that you can see on the right side of the window. All the information is already in the report, so we can simply link it to the appropriate cells in your spreadsheet. You can link, let's start with the root path, to the root path cell, the data item to the attributes we want to obtain data for. The start time would be yesterday at midnight, while the end time would be today at midnight. For the time interval, well, let's put 1 hour in pi time, so 1h. And all there is left to do is to double check the output cell and select the show timestamp option. If you click on OK, there it goes. You now have your first set of data for the target attributes over the last 24 hours. The next function that we will use is the timeData function. This function will return values of an attribute according to some predefined timestamp coming from the spreadsheet you're working on. This simply means that it will return a value for each of the timestamp that you will feed to it. Once again, to create such a function, simply click on the timeData button and fill up the different parameters needed. In this case, since we already have the timestamp defined from the previous sample data function, we only have three fields to link. The first one would be the root path, the same as earlier. Then the data item, which would be linked to the attributes we want the value for. And finally, the range of timestamp we want to obtain values for. In this case, it would be the following. Once this is done, simply double check once again the output cell and we can click on OK. You now have output values interpolated for the specified timestamps. We can now use the exact same function for the available attributes, ETH rate, SOX emission, and NOX emission. Since these are the same function, well, we can simply fast forward this section. Now that we have data for our different attributes, let's get the average value over the last hour of nitrogen oxide emission. To obtain this kind of value, we can use the calculated data function with the average calculation mode. By clicking on the calculated data function, we will be able to fill the different parameters necessary to calculate those values. Once again, the root path will be linked to the following cell. The data item will be linked to the nitrogen oxide attributes, since the calculation is actually made on this attribute. The start time and end time are set to respect the report's time range. And as for the time interval, we will set it to 1 hour. The conversion factor will stay 1, since we are using the average calculation mode and not the total mode. We've got two options to calculate the average of an attribute. Those would be either the average or the mean. The average is time-weighted, while the mean is event-weighted. Since we are working with time data, the average calculation mode is the most accurate for us, so let's just select this one. Finally, once this is done, simply double-check the output cell, and you can click on OK. We now have the average over the last hours for yesterday's nitrogen oxide emission. There is only two more PyTaLink functions that we will need to get the complete data of this report. The first one, the current value, will give us the latest value for a specific attribute that will be, in our case, our static attribute. This function is really simple to use, since all you need to define is the root path and the data item or attribute you are interested in. Simply link those two cells and click on OK. We can do the same this time for the other values for which we only need the current value. Those values would be the other static attribute that we got. The last PyTaLink function we will be using in this report is the properties function. This function will return, in our case, the property of a specific attribute, which will be the unit of measure in our reports. Once again, simply click on the appropriate button, in this case the properties one, and fill the different parameters. The root path will stay the same, and the data item will be pointing to the attributes we want to obtain the unit of measure for. And in the properties field, we'll simply select a UOM as for unit of measure. Once this is done, we can do the same for the other attributes present in our report that would need unit of measure. The report is almost done now. All there is left to add is some conditional formatting. These features from Excel can be found under the Home tab simply by clicking on conditional formatting and browse to all the different options you got there. This feature of Excel applied to your data will help you quickly identify variants in a range of values with a quick glance, and also it will help you filter visually your data. In my case, I will use a few different conditional formatting features such as the data bar and the color scale. Finally, you can add some more tools to quickly analyze your data by selecting some of the Sparkland features of Excel that you can find under the Insert tab. Once this is done, you will have a complete dynamic report, visually attractive, that you and your colleagues can share.